Hello friends, in this video I'll be helping with asynchronous transfer mode or ATM. So let's start. So it is one of the most widely used preferred technology for data transmission, as well as you can say it is replacing many other kinds of technology. One of the best example is frame relay. So why it is so much preferred and why it is replacing so much technologies, we'll be getting to know when I'll be going in bit depth. So I'll be just giving you the max overview possible. I'll be not going in too depth because I don't want this topic to be confusing for you. Okay, so let's start with it. So it is a switching technique used by telecommunication networks. So switching technique is basically a way of data transmission. So when you transfer data from one device to another device, you use asynchronous transfer mode, that is you decide how data will be transferred or in what way data will be transferred, and it is used by telecommunication networks. Now telecommunication networks early used to be only of voice because other facilities were not there, but you can see as from last one decade, with voice we transfer audio, we transfer picture also, video also, and we surf net also. So any kind of information that is exchanged can be transferred through asynchronous transfer mode. Okay, and it makes use of asynchronous time division multiplexing to encode data into small fixed size cells. So what it does, it converts data at first into a equally sized fixed cell, or you can say equally sized packets. Okay, now why it is done, I'll be telling you. Okay, so transferring of data in cells of a fixed size, so each of the packet size is equally sized. Okay, now what is the advantage of this, let me give you a bit idea about this. Okay, so if data size will be irregular, or you can say some packets are too big, some packets are medium size, some packets are small, so there will be queuing delays for small packets, right? Because small packets will be waiting for large packets to be you can say delivered through that traffic, and this will cause a lot of delay for small packets to be delivered, right? So because of these problems, what they decided is the packet size will be equal size so that there is no queuing delay for transmission of data from one device to another device. Okay, so fixed cell structure of ATM means it can be easily switched by hardware, avoiding queuing delays. Okay, and it operates at data link layer of OSI and a huge impact in development of ISDN. Now when ISDN was initially you can say introduced in 1988, it wasn't used much, but since 2000 it was used you can say at a regular basis, but internet or you can say broadband was not so popular that time. But after 2010, you can say it has emerged as the one of the biggest evolving technology. So the transmission of data, or you can say network traffic, you can say increased a lot, right? So that time the need of asynchronous transfer mode technology came into need. Okay, because before that the network traffic wasn't that much. So because it transferred data in an equally sized format, as well as there is no queuing delays and the transmission is very fast, quick, and also while transferring it selects a particular route and does not send from a random size. Okay, it selects a particular circuit or particular route, that from which routes packets will be transferred, and only from that route it transferred by packets. So because of this, it provides you a reliable way of transmission of data. Okay, and ATM cell format is of 53 bytes. Okay, so there is a fixed size that is allotted for a particular cell format. Now it doesn't matter that how big your data is, it will be divided into fixed cell size format for transmission of data from one device to another device. Now 5 bytes is for header and 48 is for payload, or you can say for your data. Okay, now header, I guess you know the basic idea before header. Header is generally for keeping what is the source address, what is the destination address, and other details related to that particular packet size. Okay, so it keeps that. So there are two main kinds of header. First is UNI header and second is NNI header. Okay, so UNI header and NNI header is you can say subtopics of ATM, but I am not going in deep, I'm just giving a brief idea about that. Okay, so if you talk about UNI header, it is used within private networks of ATM for communication between ATM endpoints and ATM switches. So there are ATM endpoints, or you can say the endpoints of ATM, or the source and the, you can say destination points, and in between the intermediate ATM switches. So it maintains a connection between ATM endpoints and ATM switches. Okay, and it is used only for private networks of ATM for communication. Whereas if we talk about NNI header, it is used for communication between ATM switches. So I hope you can understand the difference between the two. Again, I'm telling you, the UNI header is generally for you can say transmission of data between ATM endpoints and ATM switches, but in case of NNI header, the communication is between ATM switches and it is ideal for real-time low latency data such as VoIP, video, as well as high throughput data transfer like file transfer. Why so? Because if there is high throughput data like file transfer, then also packets will be easily transferred because they are equally sized format. So it is easily calculated that how much amount of data can be transferred from that traffic, right? So it makes it much easier, as well as if there is some video or if there is some low latency data, that can also be easily transferred by selecting the priorities, and there is no queuing delays at all. So this is very beneficial technology, and that is the reason why it is replacing frame relay technology, which is unreliable and which transfers data at packet switch network, or you can say it divides into small packets and selects random route for each of the packet. But in case of asynchronous, it is very reliable, as well as it selects a particular route before transmission of the packets over the network. So now let's come on to the advantages of it. So coming on to the advantages of ATM, first advantage is it provides dynamic bandwidth that is particularly suited for busty traffic. So for example, you have a large amount of data densities need to be transferred, so you can adjust your bandwidth also accordingly because of the ATM, right? So this is a very beneficial technique, and nowadays if you see, the internet has grown a lot, and that's why bursty traffic is a common problem, right? So ATM is very good in dealing with bursty traffic. Second advantage is, since all data are encoded into identical cells, data transmission is simple, uniform and predictable. So as I told you before also, the data is data is divided into equally sized fixed cells, and because of this you can decide that how data will be transferred in and how many you can say packets should be transferred at once, so that the network doesn't get stopped or stuck, or you can say blocked. Okay, so it is very simple to transfer, uniform and predictable to transfer. And third one is, small size header reduces packet overload, thus ensuring effective bandwidth uses. So what it says is, because the header size is very small, the you can say the packet, or you can say the size of the packet is effectively used and it is not overloaded, and it ensures that the bandwidth is effectively used. Because if header size will be big, then there will be a wastage of the space, or you can say, because header is not used for data, header is just used for information that what is from which packet is coming from, to where packet will be going, and other details related to that particular packet. But it does not have anything related with information, or it does not contain any information that is needs to be used. So in actual, it is useless for from the receiver's point of view, right? So that's why the header size is kept small as possible, so that the use of the packet can be effective. So once again, let's revise ATM once again, so that you can double understand it, or you can say easily, you can be full clear about ATM. Okay, so first thing is, it is a switching technique, as I told you, that is used by telecommunication network, or you can say that is used by mobile communication network for sending of audio, video, as well as internet based. Okay, so any kind of information that needs to be transferred can be transferred by asynchronous transfer mode, and generally it is used by telecommunication network. Second thing is, it is divided into fixed size cell formats that is equally sized, and whatever, it doesn't matter how big your data is, it will be divided into equally sized fixed cell format. Okay, and the size of the cell is fixed, that is of 53 bytes, in which 5 is for header and 48 is for payload. Payload is basically your information, or basically your data is. Okay, so this is fixed for every data that it needs to be transferred using asynchronous transfer mode. Okay, and it operates at data link layer, so it can do some filtering also, as well as it has a huge impact in the development of ISDN, or you can say, because we started using this in ISDN, the use of ISDN has been more effective, or you can say more better. Okay, and it has two kinds of header. First is UNI header, which is used generally for transferring data between ATM endpoints and ATM switches, and second is NNI header, which is used for communication between ATM switches. So I guess you have full clear about asynchronous transfer mode. So if you are full clear, please do hit the like button, do consider subscribing, and thanks for watching.